अज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षूरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। वंशाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्यैव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो महावदन्नाय कृष्णप्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरस्तिते। हे कृष्णकरुणासिन्धो दीनबन्धो जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिकाकान्त राधाकान्त नमस्तुते। तप्त कांचन गौराङ्गी राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी विश्वभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि। भक्त्या विहीनाय पराधलक्ष्य क्षिप्ताश्च कामादितरङ्गमध्ये कृपामयि त्वां शरणं प्रपन्ना वृन्दे नमस्ते शरणाय। यं प्रव्रजन्तमनुपेतमपेतकृत्य द्वैपायनो विरह कातरया जुहाव पुत्रेति तन्मयतया तर्वोऽभिनेतु तं सर्वभूतहृदयं मुनिवान्। तवैवास्मि न जीवामि त्वया विना इति तिथ्यै राधे तन्मय माम्। So I told that why Shankar is glorified, fine, that Prahlad is superior than me. I told this. A bhakta he can be in this world, he may be in Swarga, he may be in Vaikunth anywhere. He this body is not physical body. Like his body is like consequent. Why you both not here, come here? You, Govinda Bhakat and you. You should come here, nearest, there is so many places. I told every day. What you should come. Because Bala Purva, we will glorify Srila Bhakti Vinod Thakur and in evening classes, because all many all will be here. I had a paper here, but So, Shankara is glorifying Prahlad Maharaj. That Prahlad is superior than me. Why he is telling that he has taken darshan of Nrisimhadev? And when Nrisimhadev wanted to give him some benediction, he did not accept it. Any benediction you can take me. He told that I am not a business person. I am not worshipping you or chanting you, remembering me. That you should give me anything in return. I don't want anything in return. So please you should take me. Any desire I have for worldly things, you should take. And then he told that, yes sir, there is nothing in your heart to require anything of this world or beyond this. You should take anything from me. Again he told that my father should be forgiven. He told that, oh, it has been done previously, everything. Don't worry. Then he told that I want to take all the miseries, all the difficulties, sorrows and suffering of whole being, every being. They should be happy and they should be liberated. And you should give them Krishna Bhakti. And I will, instead of them, I will suffer for all. I will test all the bad things. For them, they will वे लोग भोगना चाह जो भोग रहे थे अब मैं भोगूंगा. Instead of them, I will taste all these things, bad things. Then Nrisimhadev became so glad and told that anyone reading this or hearing this or remembering this pastime, they will be liberated and they will have Krishna Bhakti sure. So, for a devotee, it is needed that they should not have any worldly desire. They should give up all these things. If they want so high thing, that is why Prahlad has done it. Gopis have done anything? Like Prahlad Maharaj, they decorate themselves. They see mirrors. They are very expert in cooking, expert in all arts. Because they are so superior than Prahlad. Prahlad cannot imagine that thing. But we can think of Prahlad Maharaj. We should try to read again the past tense of Nrisimhadev and Prahlad Maharaj. This is like a platform of bhakti. If you are not like Prahlad Maharaj, how you can have so highest class of brain? So we should try to do like Prahlad Maharaj. Srila Prabhupada Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur told that you should read, all devotees should read Prahlad Charitra. And he told that, I have read it 108 times. He has all the qualities written in Bhagavad, 26 qualities. Everything. He has given classes to demon children. From boyhood, he is so try to chant. Because when you will be matured in your life, your mind cannot be bent towards Krishna. From boyhood you are not a devotee, always reminding for any girl boy or boyfriend. So much attached, observed in that, and you have matured in that, then it is very hard to give up all these things, practice it. So if anyone is doing from childhood, then it will be very easy. Demons told, boys told, that now you are so very, we cannot manage our life living. We should learn something and be expert in anything, any art that we can manage money, and after that we will marriage and we will support our children, and after that when we will be old and we retired from this world, then we will chant, remember everything doing, because at that time we will be free. Prahlad Maharaj told, can you give guarantee that tomorrow you will be alive? You are not dead? Can you give guarantee that you will be old, before that you will not die? So begin from beginning. Then how to maintain our life? Don't be very for this. Why? Because we don't want suffering, sorrows. We don't want any dukkha, misery. But it's not depending on our thought. They will come, they must come. And they will quickly come upon your head, and you will have to taste all these things. Possibly. We don't want to be old, but oldness will come if you are not dying in young age. It will come. Surely it will come. We don't want death, but it will come. Why it will come? Due to our past activities. They are bound to come. Our body has made for this. So they will come. You test it gladly are weeping, but you will have to taste all these things. So why not chanting and remembering? You should do it. If there is something good that you have done in past life, it will come surely. Whether you want or not, it will come. And you will have to taste it. If you have done anything that a very big Money will come. Wealth is coming. It will come. Whether you want or not. So, don't worry for your maintenance of life. It will come automatically. Like, we are not doing anything for our maintenance. Nothing. No business, no cultivating, no job, nothing. Only chanting and remembering. Everything is coming. In Western countries, oh, you are devotee. You are coming from ISKCON, devotee. Then they tell that, also tell, that devotees have no work, no job, anything. They are devotees. They have nothing to do. They don't work. It means devotee. They tell like this. But actually, pure devotee does lakhs and lakhs times more better than these common persons. But they don't know. So, anything good or bad, it will come surely. Krishna has arranged everything. So without fear, without anything, you should try to chant, remember, do all the activity. Don't be worried for your maintenance. But you should do something which is helpful for your devotion in Krishna. You should. Then Pranad Maharaj told, if your age is of 100 years, 50 years will go in sleeping. Surely if you go in night, you will sleep. And if you are not Jitendriya, sense controller, if you are not, then you will drink and sleep more and waste your time more. But for any general person, 50 years go in sleeping. And again, 20 or 25 years, they have taken only 20 years to be expert in anything that you can maintain your life. Reading, being expert in business, doctoring, philosophers, like engineers, scientists, or anything. And 20 years from 80 to 100, you cannot do. You cannot straight your this, you cannot sit like this. Even you are not sitting like this, you cannot sit. Very hard for you. You cannot sit more than 10 minutes. We can sit like this 4 hours, 5 hours, 6 hours, chanting them, no sleep, nothing. It says that you are all old. So, from 80 to 100, it will go uselessly. So this 20 and this 20, 40 and plus 15 sleeping, 90 years spent. Now 10 years. In 10 years, you will have to marry. Children will come. You will have to support. You have to do very hard. You will try to make very good car. And so much things make a very beautiful all luxurious thing in your houses, TV and set and everything. And this will take also like 10 years. Then when will you do bhajan? So this is the report of 100 years. It will go easily. I know so many rich persons. They have never thought that what we are collecting from this world, what we are gathering to be happy, so much wealth, so much opulence, so much lands, everything. After that, what will become of that? They don't think. So Prahlad Maharaj is telling them, advising that from beginning of your life, without any fear, without any doubt, you should remember, chant and do kirtan of Krishna. Very beginning. But the seven children are telling that how you knew and how you are established in this, how we can do. Then Prahlad Maharaj is telling that due to the mercy of Narada, I became like this. When I was in the womb of my mother for 60,000 years or more than that, daily Narada Goswami used to read Bhagavatam, Ved, Upanishad, and he taught me everything. Everything. Who managed? Krishna managed. So if you are praying in the lotus feet of Krishna, he is so merciful, causeless merciful. He will arrange everything. So he will arrange any good bona fide guru. And if you want money, praise and all worldly things, then he will manage a worldly, not qualified guru. And sincerely you have done anything for that, then Krishna will arrange a very qualified guru for you. Like Valmiki ji, was like a robber and dragon. But causeless mercy of Narada was there. He could not utter Ram Ram. Then his guru there told that you should utter only Maram Ram. We are doing Siddha.
Properly.
But nothing is coming. And he did
opposite,
and he realized Ram and he had the mercy of Ram and everything. He wrote Ramayana before Ram. So if Guru is bona fide, devotees will be bona fide. But it is not guaranteed. If devotees from any chaste and qualified Vaishnava Guru is taking, but he is not following his Gurudev, then what will be to? What will be? Disciples should carry order and obey him and follow his character. Then mercy will come more. So he is telling that Guru Shushrusha, at least one should serve his Gurudev. And whatever you do, do for the pleasure of Krishna. You should not sleep for you. Someone are sleeping for their own. If you are sleeping, sleep for Krishna. That for tomorrow, I will be very bona fide servant of Krishna. Don't eat. Don't take anything. Eat. You should serve Mahaprasadam. Like this. So if you are following Prahlad Maharaj, very quickly you will promote him to just Vaishnava, qualified Vaishnava. So we should try. But when Narad came, at once, he was going to Vaikuntha. But who told? That now Krishna in Dwarka and also he is in Sutta. So you should not go there. You should go there to Prahlad Maharaj in Sutta Hills. And quickly he went there. When he went, Prahlad Maharaj, as usual, went to do pranam, shastan pranam, but Narad Rishi took him in his hand and began to glorify. Prahlad told that, oh Gurudev, we have never done like this, but today you are doing all these things. Why? You have been changed. Then Narad told, now I am knowing your all glories. You are so near and dear to Krishna. And he began to glorify. You know mukti, what is mukti? Mukti is essential for all, whether he is devotee or not. Agra hai mukti, tave sarva bandhanas tave sahaite pare Shri Krishna avatar. If four persons are attacking me, and they have closed my eyes, nose, mouth. And if in a minute you are not breathing, then what it will be? You will die. You want mukti or not? That they should give up me. This is mukti. The attachment, worldly attachment are all daggers. Anyone is not our enemy, but we are own our enemy. My mind is only. Always attacking us. So if anyone becomes liberated from all these worldly attachments, then he is a liberated person. So we must be like this. So we cannot ignore. So, but Prahlad Maharaj never wanted this also. And he was always fearless. Hiranyakashipu did everything to kill him. But he was never any fear for this. So a devotee should be like this. Don't fear in your devotee. Krishna is protector. He is Shiva. We should take shelter of Krishna. He has taken shelter. So a devotee should be like this. If whole world is against you, they cannot do anything. If Krishna is helpful, and if Krishna is opposite, then whole world cannot help you a little. Never. So a devotee should be like this. So we can see everything in this Prahlad Maharaj. Narada told Prahlad, Prahlad, you are so fortunate. From boyhood, you have pure bhakti in the Lord feet of Krishna. Perhaps you do or you know or not, there was a Brahmin. He was quite young. And he was so beautiful. He was very learned in Ved, Upanishad and all things. But misfortunately, he was attached to any prostitute. He gave her all everything, his wife, children, wife, father, mother. And he used to go to that priest, prostitute, whose whole wealth he gave to her. But she was not satisfied. One day, he had nothing to give her. She rebuked him. When she rebuked, then he was feeling so much pain here. I have given my whole thing, my dharma, religious and everything. I have left my wife, so chaste and beautiful. I left my children. Everything I have lost for this. But now she is rebuking me and telling that go away from here. So he was so worried and left that place in mourning. He was weeping and he was trying to suicide. So he was going to a forest. When he went there, it was now dark, it was evening, night. Tigers and bears were roaring. And it was cold day, rain was coming. Anyhow, he took shelter in a broken temple. And whole night weeping, whole day nothing taking. In the night also that the prostitute, also she was now wife of that Brahmin boy. And she followed and she was also taking shelter there, but not knowing that my beloved is here. So she was in one corner and he was in one corner. She was also waiting whole night and they did not took anything. No water, no grain, no chapati, nothing. Luckily, that day was the day of Nrisimhadev. So, for Nrisimhadev, not for Nrisimhadev, but at that day, they were observing fasting and whole day, night and day waking. Next day, they went and became happy. So this boy was Prahlad Maharaj became. And his wife became, that prostitute became his wife. So from beginning, they were devotees. And Narada Goswami met him. So from boyhood, he was like so. We can give up our these things, devotional life, if any circumstance will come, difficulty will come. But he never did like so. So we should try to follow him. After this, Prahlad Maharaj hearing, he He tells that Gurudev, I don't know why you have changed. I'm not a pure bhakta. Never. Nishimdev has not come to protect me, to save me. Why he has come? He has come to protect bhakti. If he is not saving bhakta from any difficulty, then anyone let do bhakti to Krishna. So you have Krishna. Nishimadeva has only come to protect his bhakti. Secondly, he has not come for me, Nishimadeva. For whom he has come? For Jaya Devan, Jaya and Vijay. Because they are favorite to Nishimadeva, to Narayana. Because they have done everything, they are parshad. Parshad means?
Associates.
Associates of Narayan always. Anyone cannot fall from Vaikuntha. But we see that Jaya and Vijaya have fallen down from Vaikuntha. Actually they have not fallen. They have come here as a demon to please their Prabhu. Because Narayan wanted to taste Virash. Virash means?
Heroism.
And that is why Sanakshanandan, Sanatan were called by Krishna Yogmaya. And they became angry. They never become angry in their whole life. So, Yogmaya made them like this. That Narayan wishes will be fulfilled. So don't think that Jaya Vijaya have fallen from Vaikuntha. They are always parikar of Narayan. So Narayan has come as a Nishimadeva for their Jaya and Vijaya. Or Narayan has come to fulfill the wishes of Chatushan. How that they have given this
curse
to Jaya Vijaya to fulfill them. So he has not come. And Vamadeva is always in Sutal. Why he is in Sutal? That Bali Sutna, Bali Sutna, Bali, oh, kya Maharaj?
Bali
Maharaj, no. Are kya naam usha? Bali Maharaj. He should not mix with any demon. Otherwise he will again conquer that Swarga. And he will take charge of Swarga. And he will drive out all the demons and demigods from there. Once Ravana came there and he was in the palace and Vamandeva was on the gate. When Ravana came to fight with Bali Maharaj, to conquer him. At once, Vamandeva from knocked from his toe or his this feet. And he fell down on the sea nearer to Lanka, 1,000 miles away from there. Why? Because if Ravana will come, then there will be two friends and they will again do so many harms. So Vamandeva is on the gate of Bali Maharaj only to give God that he should not do wrong to demigods. Not for me that he is giving darshan to me all day. Not this fact. So there are so many reasons. So, if you want to see any near and dear to God, to Krishna, you can see Hanuman. I am not Sar Nishingharev. Sometimes I have seen him. Sometimes. One time I have seen on the shore of sea, ocean. I was praying and he gave a very little darshan. Very little. Perfectly he disappeared. I agree that I do a smart of Vishnu. Smart money?
Remembrance.
Meditation. But my meditation is always disturbed. Sometimes my mind goes that protecting my kingdom, looking after my kingdom. My family is there. Something is there. So my remembrance always with obstacles.
Disturbed.
But Hanuman always serving Ram. Without Ram's service he cannot be. I have never served. I have not given a glass of water to my Nishingare. I have not what?
Massage
the feet of Nishingare. And in the other hand, Hanuman, he is Naishik Brahmachari. He was not married. Mainly he had no marriage. Because my half of energy will go to my wife. So he never. And from why would he used to tell Ram, 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 Ram? He was so learned because he is himself Shankar. So much learned. When he first met with Ram, he came in the shape of a Brahmin, very learned. And he was so sweet speaking. Very intelligent. In some word he can express so many thoughts. If anyone can tell his all things, hearts, in very simple and very little words, then he is expert.